For this lesson, you need to open World Sales from your Sample Files folder. When you prepare a chart for a PowerPoint presentation or for inclusion in a high-quality colour publication, you want the chart to look professional and interesting. A gradient background fill will put the finishing touch to your chart so that it looks like it was produced by a professional graphic artist. So let's begin by creating a clustered column chart from the entire range. To do that, I click on any cell in the range and then the Insert tab on the ribbon, and in the Charts group, Insert Column Chart. Then I'll select the Clustered Column Chart Type from the 2D column group. Now I think I'll switch the rows and columns. In other words, I want USA, Europe and Other, shown along the x-axis, to change places with the January, February and March, shown in the legend. You learnt how to do this in Lesson 513. So first I need to click just inside the border of the chart to activate it, if it's not already activated, and then click Chart Tools Design on the ribbon, and in the Data group, switch Rows and Columns. And when I click, you can see that January, February, March are now shown along the x-axis, and USA, Europe, Other are now shown in the legend. Now we're going to add a gradient fill to the chart background. To do that, I need to first activate the chart by clicking just inside the border, and then I need to hover over the chart area element. To do this, I move the mouse until I see the chart area tip. Then I right-click the mouse button and choose Format Chart Area from the shortcut menu, and the Format Chart Area task pane appears. I want to add a gradient fill to the chart area, so I'll click the Fill option to display the flyout menu. And you can see that I have many options for fill types, and one is the gradient fill that I want. So I'll click the Gradient Fill option button, and now I can see several ways in which I can customize my gradient fill. Well, I'm going to use a preset, so I'll click the Preset drop-down button, and you can see many gradient fills that I can quickly choose for the chart. I think I'll choose the Light Gradient Accent 4 Yellow Gradient Fill, so I'll click, and now you can see the gradient fill previewed on the chart. If you want to, you can explore the Type, Direction, Angle, Transparency and other settings until you're happy with the fill. But I think I like the fill just the way it is. So I'll click the Close button to close the Format Chart Area task pane. I'll click Close, and I've now applied my gradient fill. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name Gradient Fill. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 526, Add a Gradient Fill to a Chart Background.